In this blog, we will try to see how to accept a user input from Python programming. So you can notice that from this tutorial, we are going to use PyCharm for creating our Python project. So you may also use IDLE depending upon your requirement. So now let's get started with the coding. So for example, consider a variable x equal to 10 and y equal to 20. And here I'm just trying to make sure how to do a simple calculation that I think you are very much familiar by now. Actually, in IDLE, you can just directly provide Z, and when you tap on enter, you will be getting the output. But we are using an IDE, that is, we are using PyCharm, so we need to specifically provide print, and inside which we need to provide our variable. So now let's try to run the code. And here you can see we have got 30, and you might have noticed that we have got the output in a fraction of a second. Now we have provided 4 lines of code here for getting the output, that is the sum of the 2 numbers here. So yes, we have seen the same example in IDLE also, and now we try to accept the user input. So in every programming, it's the primary aspect that we need to accept the user input. For example, in your daily life, you might have used a calculator where you accept the user input and you calculate the sum and provide it as a result. So now let us do the same here. So for considering the user input, we have a method called input here, you can see, and by making use of this, you can accept the value and store it into the variable x here. And let us do the same for y also here. So we have provided 2 input methods for each variable x and y. And now let us try to see the output. So here you are not able to see anything in the console here, right? So, but it is waiting for our input here. So it is accepting the first variable x, so I will be providing 5 and tap on the enter button. So it will be accepting the second value, that is y here, and I will be providing 6 for the value of y here. And now 5 is stored into x and 6 is stored into y, and it will be calculated and the final result will be storing into Z, and we are going to print the Z finally. And now so let us try to tap on the enter button after entering the value for variable Y here. We have got 56 here. So you might think we are performing a calculation and we are getting 5 and 6 combined. So you might be wondering why we have got 56 here. 5 plus 6, you need to get 11, right? So whenever you are trying to use this input method, it will be considering the input value as a string here. So here it will be considering x as a string and y as a string. We are going through concatenation of 2 strings here, but in reality we need to add the 2 numbers available in those particular variables, so for which you can just wrap it inside int here and do the same for y also. And now try to run the code here. You can just tap on the button here every time. You need not go to the run menu, and from there click on the run here, and also you can go through the shortcut here. So now let's try to provide 5 and 6 now, and now this time you have got 11 here. Why? Because we are converting the string value of x into integer here, and we are adding them and providing the final result here. So just make sure that whenever you are using the input method, the value will be accepted in terms of string and not any other data type which you are expecting. And also let us see one more thing here. As we have started using PyCharm, let us also see the debug option here. So here I want to debug this particular fifth line here. So just tap here, you will be getting a red dot. So now go to the run option available here, and inside which select the debug main, and here it is connected to debugger now. So here let us provide 5 and 6, and now you are able to see the values of x and y as 5 and 6 respectively. And now step here, you can see the values of x is 5 and the value for y is 6, and the total is 11 here. 5 plus 6 is 11. Tap on the button F7 here, and here you can see we have got 5, 6, and when you again tap on the F7, you will be getting the final result, that is 11, which is stored into the variable z here, and the same we are trying to print onto our console. So yes, this is it for this tutorial on how to consider the user inputs and how to make use of the PyCharm. So this is the first tutorial using PyCharm, and if you are having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. And if you are the beginner and you are watching the video for the first time, I suggest you to go through our previous tutorials on Python programming. If you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Python.